Don't look at your clock. Don't be afraid. You're about to be swayed by the boogeyman monster who lives under your bed, who loves you so much, he wants to rip off your head.
Grab a blanket, turn off your lights, and don't ever, ever look under your bed. Come into my world and be ready for 6 boogeyman stories from childhood. The boogeyman? I have been a regular visitor to this. I feel comfortable now to share my story with you. This will be the first story I submit. The story I'm about to tell you happened a few years ago. I was 13 at the time. I am 26 now, and this still haunts me to this day. I stayed with my parents in a quiet suburb in South Africa. I grew up in that house, and my parents still stay there to this day. I remember waking up in the early morning hours, feeling panicked and scared. It felt like someone was watching me. Like I wasn't alone. I didn't move but scan the room with my eyes. I didn't see anything. I closed my eyes and prayed. Soon after, I fell asleep again and didn't think much of it. A few days passed and nothing happened. I then woke up again, with the same fear and panic. I looked around my room again, and that's when I saw it. It was sitting on my desk in front of my bed. It was small, like a garden gnome. It had yellow eyes, sharp little teeth, and pointed fingers. It just stared at me. I never felt so scared in my life. I screamed, and my dad came to my room. As soon as he put the light on, the creature was gone. My dad didn't believe me when I told him what I have seen. He thought it was just a bad dream. It felt so real. I know I was awake, and I know I saw it, and it saw me. I slept in my parents' room the rest of the night. I was now scared to go to bed, to be alone in my room at night. I could always feel it watching me. It also started to scratch the underside of my bed at night. I once again woke up and saw the creature sitting on my desk. He stared at me and smiled. The most evil smile I have ever seen. I was frozen with fear. This went on for years. My parents thought I had an overactive imagination and watched too many scary movies and didn't take it seriously. Whenever I saw the creature, I just covered my face with my duvet, prayed, and hoped I will fall asleep quickly. It seemed like it didn't like that I ignored it, and things got worse. I saw him sitting on my desk again. I just closed my eyes and covered my face. I knew he was still there. I could feel him watching me. I then felt him jump onto my bed. I didn't dare move. I have never been this scared in my life. I didn't dare look. I just laid there. I could feel him scratching my arm, and I screamed. My dad came and put the lights on, and the creature was gone. I slept in my parents' room again. The next morning, I saw the 4 scratches on my arm, but my parents said that I must have done it in my sleep. I told a friend what was happening, and luckily, he believed me. He told me this thing thrives on fear and that I should sleep with a Bible under my pillow and tell it to go away. I did just that. I could feel him sometimes watching me, but never saw him. Again, I was 16 at the time. This is when it got even creepier. I was doing much better. 2 years had passed without any incidences. I was 18 at the time. I stayed over at a friend's house. We all slept in front of the TV. Then, her boyfriend screamed in the early hours of the morning. I woke up and I could feel the creature looking at us. I knew it was there. "The boogeyman is here," her boyfriend screamed over and over again. I ran to put the lights on, and that's when her boyfriend told me about the creature, the same creature I saw when I was younger. I saw the small scratch marks on his arm, and that just freaked me out. I was trying to convince myself for so long that it wasn't real. Has anyone seen anything like this before? What is it? I'm 26 now, and I haven't seen or felt it again after that night. Military Brat's Boogeyman. I was, and still am, a military brat. My first paranormal encounters began with my earliest memories of my life. My father was a computer analyst and a programmer, and as such, we got to live on base in a mobile home park. Since my earliest memories were of mobile home parks, I've always enjoyed sleeping with the sound of the rain pitter-pattering upon a metal roof. Now, I remember several odd things happening to me during the years we lived in the mobile home park. So I think my memories were along about the 1969 to 1973 years, as I remember kindergarten along up to third grades. I remember one time seeing an orange tabby cat sleeping curled up upon the couch in the living room. I approached it to take a closer look. I was curious about this cat because we didn't have an orange cat living with us. My memories are odd at this point because I recall that the cat seemed strange in that it neither had a head nor a tail, just a body. It struck me as being rather odd at the time. I could look at the cat with my eyes and yet not just with my eyes alone, as I felt my eyes almost go cross-eyed looking down at it. After a couple of blinks, my mom asked me what I was doing. She was in the kitchen area, and when I answered her, I turned away and told her about the cat. When I turned back, it wasn't there anymore. Later on, I'd managed to capture a pet turtle. I really should have left it alone, but my dad indulged me and allowed me to bring it home. One time, one evening, I heard it scraping along the hallway from the living room to the bedrooms, to one master and the kids' room with bunk beds, and the one bathroom. My dad told me to attend to the turtle before he got lost. I ignored it because I was at an interesting point in my comic book I was reading. The sound of the turtle scraping along stopped at that point. I thought at the time that it was due to the fact that all the doors were closed and he had nowhere to go. I was wrong somehow. As soon as I got done with the comic book, I went to look for him. I couldn't find him anywhere. I searched several places over and over. I never did find him. All of the doors to the hallways were closed. I did not hear him scraping back down the hallway. Years later, my dad told me that when he moved the mobile home around 74 or 75, he found the turtle shell underneath the house. No other bones other than its shell, and it was lying in the crawl space underneath that was completely inaccessible. No one was allowed to go in there, and I wouldn't even go due to all the cobwebs. In short, there were no holes or such that would have allowed the turtle to crawl directly into the crawl space. The most significant event was the late night one. I remember it fairly well, even though it was nearly 40 years ago. I was in the top bunk, my sister was in the bottom, mom and dad were in the master bedroom, and I had just woken up for no apparent reason. Something wasn't right about the house. Why? I couldn't tell at the time. Then I heard footsteps near the front door. But it was more than just footsteps. I could sense it. I was lying on my right side and I could feel that my pajama tops were pushed up near my diaphragm. Again, I was always a restless sleeper. Lying there, I could hear Dad snoring in his bedroom and my sister was just snuffling a bit in her sleep. And there was someone in the living room, slowly walking towards the bedrooms as if trying to keep from making any noises. But I couldn't prevent the slight depression its weight made upon the floor when it passed the wall between it and me. At which point, I was definitely very nervous. I thought about yelling, but I just couldn't for some reason. Then the door to my bedroom opened. I could tell because I could feel the slight breeze generated by the door as it swung open. upon my bare half back. At this point, I had my eyes firmly shut due to the notion that whatever it was, I simply must not look at it, which would have been difficult since I was lying and facing the wall and not towards the door. Now at this point, I could sense it. It was and still is difficult to describe. It was there and it had mass. I could feel it nearby, only a foot or two away from me, yet I also felt that it was wrong. Some unnameable part of my senses told me that it was somehow less than it should be. Now, as I lay there experiencing all of this, it moved. It put something upon my back. It felt like a wiener, but cold, and it stayed attached to my back. It had a sort of sticky feel to it. I was a bit incensed at this, so I decided I was going to shift over to my left side and open my eyes, and then confront it, which I proceeded to do, with my back touching the sheet along the way and definitely feeling something between me and the sheets right along my spine. I was nerving myself up to flinch open my eyes and see it when I felt a tickling along my right side belly, still exposed. I soon realized what it was, a hand trying to reach over and get whatever it was attached to my back. The hand felt feathery light, as if it was trying very hard to not let it touch my skin. The number of fingers felt different too, like it did not have enough fingers or no thumb attached to its hand. I quickly lost my resolve to confront it at that point. After feeling it fumble after the attachment, I turned back onto my right side to give it ready access. At this point, my fear increased dramatically for some reason. I almost felt its skeptical attitude about me being fully asleep. Finally, after what seemed so long, it reached out and took the thing from my back. I could feel some of my skin pulled out for a bit when it pulled it off. It pinched a bit. I was even more scared at that point as I suddenly realized I couldn't hear it breathing. There seemed to be some kind of residue that still clung to my back. It was placed along what would have been near the top of my pelvis. Finally, after a while, I could hear it stomp back the way it came in and exit the house. At that point, I was so exhausted that I fell asleep again. Naturally, I was met with complete and utter skepticism from Mom and Dad. I persisted with the notion that it was for real, at which point my dad decided that I was no longer going to be allowed to watch some of my favorite TV shows, The Night Stalker, Outer Limits, and The Twilight Zone, which angered me to no end. That also taught me the importance of keeping my mouth shut against non-believers concerning my experiences, of which I've had many more. I've had a lot of predictive dreams since then. I've had the occasional vision, a couple of UFO sightings, eerie feelings, and some truly incredible hunches. For the longest time in high school, I annoyed my family and friends by saying hello, whoever, whenever they called, and invariably, I was right. This was long before caller ID. Now, I've been in the military since then, the Air Force for me, and I've got to enjoy survival training for combat communication school. Therein, I got to enjoy sleep deprivation to the point of hallucinating. In retrospect, my childhood night terror was not a hallucination. Little Green Gremlin. Intro. At around the age of 5 or 6, I lived alone with my mother in New York City, Manhattan. My mother's part of the family had a history of women who were experts in ghosts, saints, and seeing into the future. Currently, my mother's half-sister's grandmother is the last to practice such things, and she lives in Miami, Florida. I've always wanted to ask her what I saw that day in my father's house. At first, I thought maybe I was dreaming, considering I was so young when I saw it. I asked anyone in the family if they had seen such a thing, and my uncle said he'd seen it before. It would stare at him with small green eyes while he was trying to sleep, and then vanished. I am now sure of what I saw because he explained to me what he saw, and it matched the description of the little ghost. I'm posting this here to see if maybe someone else can help me understand a little bit more about the type of entity or ghost that I saw. Story. It was around probably 9 or 10 p.m. at night, and my mom tucked me into bed. The house was really dark, and I asked for a glass of water. After I asked, my mother left the kitchen to get the glass of water. I waited for her and looked around my father's room. Nothing had been moved since he left. While looking around, something caught my eye. At the top of my father's closet, a swirling green misty orb wafted over my father's large black boots. It had appeared out of thin air, and I watched, terrified, as the orb constructed itself into what looked like two little greenish feet, then greenish pants, then what looked like a small greenish jacket or vest top. Finally, the head appeared. It had a thick whitish greenish beard and a pointed hat. He looked very vintage and old, with beady eyes and wrinkles pulling at his pointed nose. From what I saw, it looked angry. It resembled a gremlin or a gnome thing. It opened its mouth but made no noise. Its eyes were cold, and it looked very indulged in my father's shoes. He tried putting his feet in them, but kept walking right out of them, like his ghostly state couldn't allow him to physically wear my father's shoes. He tried multiple times, but couldn't put them on. He became more and more frustrated. Finally, he gave up and threw a kind of small tantrum. From this point, I can't remember if he saw me quickly and vanished, or he heard my mom walking back to my room with water and vanished. Since then, I've never seen him again. From my uncle's experience with the gremlin, it would stare at him at night and even appear in his room whole while he was trying to sleep. Each time, my uncle would feel something staring at him and would look at him each time. Every time he did this, the gremlin would move a bit back, but still glare at him very hard. My father lived with my uncle and slept in the next room, but when I asked him about it, he said he never saw it. I don't know if it ever watched my dad or he didn't notice it. I wonder if the ghost has left the house since that day and what ties it has to my family. The thing walked through our living room. What was it? This story happened many, many years ago, when I was very young, but the image is still clearly burnt into my memory. I've never forgotten what it looked like, and thinking back on it now, this perhaps was the place where all my paranormal experiences and belief in ghosts began. First, let me explain a very brief history of the house. I remember being a young child and looking at the house with my parents for the first time, as a realtor led us through it. I recall them saying that they were selling it for a cheaper price than all the surrounding houses because the last owner had died in that house. My first strange experiences began when someone started tickling me at night as I lied in bed. I look around to find no one there. Though sometimes in my dreams, I'd have a very vivid dream of a specter-like thing with black eyes smiling and standing over me as it tickled me. Another night, I woke up to the very real sensation of a hand covering my face. I could feel its long, skeleton-like fingers wrapping around my cheeks, but when I peered nervously into the darkness of my room, I didn't really notice anything except the natural shadows of my room. There are other things I remember that happened, but only faintly because I was so young and distracted most of the time. I won't bother with those here. but the most haunting, chilling memory of all happened late one night. I was having a hard time sleeping, and as I laid in my bed thinking about what I should do, then I heard noises and bumps coming from the kitchen. My bedroom connected with both the kitchen and the living room, but the door to the kitchen was always kept closed. On just the other side of it, I heard thuds, and it sounded like someone had walked up the stairs from the basement into the kitchen, and they were now doing something in there. I thought I'd even heard something brush up against or slightly move the doorknob to the door separating my room with the kitchen. The door never opened though, and I hid my head underneath the blankets for a minute or so. Eventually, curiosity got the best of me though, as I heard what sounded like noises proceeding out of the kitchen and into the living room. It's important to add here that from my bedroom, I could view the living room and the window that lit up the whole room due to the presence of an old-style lamp outside. Because of this, I could get a full view of the very grotesque creature that walked out of the kitchen and into the living room. I wish I could explain it to you perfectly, but any way I explain it couldn't give it full justice. I swear that what I saw this night is absolutely true and really happened to me. I need to know if other people have seen anything like this or what people think this was. It's always bothered me to this day. What is most peculiar and most ugly about this thing that walked straight into our living room was not... it was not the shape of a human. Most importantly, its legs were distorted as if they had been severely broken. It walked like a chicken with knees the other way. It hunched over and I could see that it had long arms and long fingers that hung down. I was scared out of my mind and hid underneath the blankets, closing my eyes and praying to myself. I've never seen it since that night, but that was many years ago and it still haunts me to this day. I can't explain what it was, but I'm very curious about what I saw. Maybe a demon? Anyways, thanks for reading. Comments are greatly appreciated. Childhood sighting needs explanation. Before I moved to North California, I lived in Georgia for 12 years. We lived in a great house. I have such fond memories, except for a few. There is one experience in particular that has haunted me through the years. Our house was a nice one. It had 3 bedrooms and 2 baths, a kitchen, utility room, den, and a formal living room. I started to take piano lessons in elementary school. My parents bought me a beautiful piano with real ivory keys. They put it in the living room since it was really not used that often. Every night, I would go in for 30 minutes and practice. I always felt a little uneasy in that room, but I continued to practice. Whenever we had family that stayed with us, we always folded out the hideaway bed that was in the living room couch to accommodate our visitors. My grandmother had come down to stay with us for a week and we had set her up in the living room. It was the weekend and my grandmother had taken my older sister out and about. My mother and I were the only ones home. She asked me to go lie down and rest for about an hour. She was in the middle of changing the sheets on my bed, so she suggested that I lay down on the bed in the living room. I walked into the room and I immediately felt unsettled. I shut the French doors behind me and hopped up onto the bed. I curled myself into a ball and scooted to the very middle. The doors, as I mentioned, were French style, so they had little windows over the surface of the whole door. I looked over at the doors and noticed an odd reflection. It was a small creature, about 2 or 3 feet tall, and it was black in color. I could not make out a face, but it had 2 arms and 2 legs. It was human-like. It also appeared to have very small horns on its head. It was behind me, nearing the dining table we had. I quickly turned and looked over my shoulder, but there was nothing there. When I looked at the doors again, it began to walk towards me. I looked again back to try and see it, but there was nothing. I stole 1 last glance at the reflection and screamed. When I saw it was trying to get on the bed with me, I flew out of the room and never went in again. I stopped taking piano lessons because I was too scared to go in the living room. I've never figured out what I saw. It was so odd and it still frightens me. I'm hoping maybe someone will know something and help me. I got such great feedbacks about my previous story I submitted, and I'm hoping to get that again. Thanks for taking the time to read my story. The Boogeyman. I truly believe that young children and animals can see things that we adults cannot. Mainly because of the stories my mother told me when I was around 18 months to 2 years old. This happened to me when I lived in Florida. I currently live in New York now. I still have strange occurrences happen to me to this day, but that's for another story at another time. This entity I experienced when I was a toddler was my best friend. My mom would tell me one random day I started to talk to my imaginary friend, and she also told me I called it the Boogeyman. This entity did no harm on me or my family, even though the Boogeyman is based off something evil. I have no idea why I called it that. It was just the name I gave it. My mom told me about strange things started happening since I started talking to it. Like the oven would turn on by itself, the lights would flicker, the coasters on the coffee table would move, and the toilets would flush by themselves. One night, while everyone was asleep except my mother and my sister, they were talking in my sister's room, and all of a sudden my mom sees the kitchen lights flicker on and off. Thinking it was one of my brothers, she went into the kitchen to catch my brother in the act. She saw no one. Checked my brother's room and saw they were all fast asleep, along with my other sister in her room. She called my dad because she was quite scared, but my dad, he didn't believe in this stuff, so said it was probably one of the boys playing a joke. Every day I would talk and play with it, even talk to it when I was in the bathtub. My mom dismissed it at first, but the strange things kept happening, and she started thinking it was something more than just an imaginary friend. One day, my mom asked, "What does the Boogeyman look like?" And I told her it had red hair and it was in fact a woman. Years later, my mom brought up the story to me when I was around 10 or 11. What she told me didn't freak me out. It was more comforting than anything. My mom told me that the day she asked me what my friend looked like, I had described my dead grandmother on my father's side. Both of my dad's parents died before I was born. My mom's died years later when I was older. My mother and I firmly believe that my grandmother came to meet me. You see, my grandmother loved to bake, so my mom says that it was probably her turning on the stove. And from other stories and things I've read about spirits trying to get attention, I believe that she was trying to get my mother and father's attention. Thank you for reading my story.